Hello everybody, this is a video showing you how to use Scraper API, a proxy API for web scraping. And if you do any Python web scraping projects and you find that you're unable to access a site because it's forbidden, then this may well be a good product for you to check out. To sign up, you can actually get 5,000 free API credits without even putting in any credit card details. So let's just have a look at that. I'm just on the sign-in page, which is what you get if you just click on free trial. And yeah, let's just say I'm not a robot. Okay, select all squares with taxis, none. Fire hydrants. Do you hate these as much as I do? They are so annoying. Right. Say that you agree to the terms and conditions, email address. You can use your Google or your GitHub account if you've already got that. So sign up with email, create an account, activate your account. Start using your account by validating your email address. Send activation email. So now if I go to my Google account, okay, so great to see you've signed up. Quick start guide, all that jazz. So if we go here, activation link, click to activate your account. Welcome to the Scrapy API. Your account is now active. And this is what we want. So don't copy this thinking you can use it, because I will have deleted it by the time this video is uploaded. However, what we can see here is an API key, which is what we need to put into our code, which will then verify us as users with Scraper API, and then we can go off and do some web scraping. So there's a curl example here. And what this does is it goes to httpbin.org, just paste that example in. So all I've done is I've opened up terminal and I've just copied in the code that you saw here, sample API code. And it's already put in my personal API key. So when you follow the steps that I've just done, it will give you your own unique API key in that sample code. Let's move on top, click off of that so that you can, there you go. So let's run this and it returns the origin. So we've already got the free 5,000 API credits and they last for 1 month, one calendar month, I believe. And here we go, getting started, API key and authentication. So we've already done this bit. We've got the API key. You can use API to scrape web pages, API endpoints, images, documents, PDFs, or other files just as you would any other URL. Note, there is a 2 megabyte limit per request. Okay, I don't see that being an issue. There are three ways which you can send GET requests to Scraper API. So you can do it via the endpoint. You can do it via the SDK, which we'll look at in a minute. And then there's a proxy port, which I'm not going to cover here. So choose whichever option best suits your scraping requirements. Important note, regardless of how you invoke the service, we highly recommend you set 60 seconds timeout in your application to get the best possible success rates, especially for some hard to scrape domains. Yeah, so don't expect a response quickly. Sometimes it may take a while because they'll be doing lots of different things at their end, probably trying different rotating IP addresses and so on. So request to the API endpoint, method one. This is curl, this is what we just did. Let's skip this and go straight to the Python section, which is what hopefully everyone's more interested in. So what we have here is import requests, payload, and API key. So that's obviously the name of the key, and that's the value. So you see this bit here? That's where we will substitute our API key that we've received from Scraper API when we signed up, which you saw me use just now. Okay, so this is the example code. And as you can see, they've already completed the request for us as a GET request. The parameters are the payload, and the payload is the API key and the target URL. So let's run this. Just remember that there's brackets around the print statement. If you copy their example, there won't be, because they wrote it in Python 2.7. So let's just try this. Python 3, scraper 1, python.py. And it's returned the IP address of the target site, which is what we were expecting. So good. So far, so good. Okay, so just to expand on that fairly basic example, let's just look at how we could scrape amazon.co.uk, Amazon hot new releases. Here we go. So what I've done is just gone into developer tools. So just go over anything you want, right click, inspect. I'm using Firefox, but this works in most browsers. Then say, for instance, we wanted to get the text, so then we just go there and inspect, and that should take us down to the relevant part. And it's already missing because I've cut it out. Let's just refresh the page, and there you can see, yeah, it's already on that. So what we do is just double click on that, click on it again. There we go. So if I do right click, cut, then you can be sure that it's copied or cut the exact bit you need. Minimize that, and then go into your scraper. What I've done is I've added this line here, from BS4 import beautiful soup. Soup equals beautiful soup. Then in brackets, you pass it the object HTML, which you've got from your request.get to the scraper API. You pass it as LXML. You don't have to, there's other options, but LXML works fine. Then you say soup, so you just update your soup object, and you use soup.select. And because we're looking for a div, we use a full stop, and then we just pass in the class name. So good, we've got our selector prefixed by the full stop. Let's exit that, and if we run it rather than open it with Vim, it takes a few seconds, and there you see it's gone off and it's got all of that information. Obviously we would then need to parse it, but you can see all the data's there. So you've got all of the book names, the bullet that missed, fast family food, easy meals for you and your baby, prepped in 10 minutes, what mummy makes, the world's worst pets. So you can parse all this, and I'm not going to cover that here because this is really focusing on how to use Scraper API. And this is just a couple of examples, which hopefully will be enough to get you going. So yeah, hopefully this has been useful. Don't forget the link to Scraper API with a discount code, DrPy10, will get you, I think, 10% off, if not more. And yeah, good luck. Any questions, add me a comment in the comments below. So yeah, thank you for watching.